Hello everyone, and welcome back to the virtual class of Python Application Programming. In the previous class, we had begun databases and SQL in Python, wherein we discussed introduction to database, where we understood the meaning of database, examples of various database management softwares available like Oracle, MySQL, Microsoft SQL Server, PostgreSQL, SQLite, etc. And the reason why we will be using SQLite. Now, as I already told you, the reason was because it is a very common database and is already built into Python. Next, we moved on to several database concepts where we got introduced to new concepts like relational database and how tables, rows, and columns are referred as relation, tuple, and attribute respectively in relational database. Later, we also saw database browser for SQLite and then created a table with a name called tracks. Today, we will discuss two important concepts related to database. Number one, inserting records into a database, that is how to enter data into the created table, and structured query language summary, that is nothing but your SQL summary. Moving on. So until last class, what we did was we created an empty table having two columns, namely title and place, which looked something like this. Today, what we will do is we will insert records or data into this table. Now, this we will do by using an insert command. Again, if you look at this code, what we see is we begin by making a connection to the database and obtaining the cursor. We can then execute SQL commands using this cursor. This I had already told you. Next, we use the SQL insert command, which indicates which table we are using and then defines a new row by listing the fields we want to include, that is titles and place in this case, which is followed by values we want to be placed in the new row. Then we specify the values as question marks to indicate that the actual values are passed in as a tuple or tuple. That is, you can see my way, 15. That is nothing but a tuple. As a second parameter to the execute call. To repeat, what we are doing here is we are inserting or adding data into the table using the insert statement. So the statement goes like this. Insert into tracks, where tracks is the name of the table you want to insert data into. Next, we have the name of columns, namely title and place, followed by the values keyword. Now, we specify the values as question marks here to indicate that the actual values are passed in as a tuple. That is thunderstock, 20 as a second parameter to the execute call. So, this execute method has two parameters. One is this with question marks and other is this with the actual values. So when you insert these values like thunderstock and 20, the first value will go into the first column, that is the title column, and the second value will go into the second column, that is the place column. Similarly, if you want to insert another record, you need to follow the same syntax and only change the values, as in this case it is my way and 50. Lastly, we use the commit method to store the inserted records permanently onto the database table. Now, the reason why we are using this commit method is that if this method is not applied, then the insertion will be temporary and will affect only the current run of the program. That's why we are using this commit method. So with this, we have successfully inserted two records into the table named tracks. Until here, we have created a table and inserted records into it. Next step is to visualize the data. And so for that, we have the select command. Now we use the select command to retrieve the rows we just inserted into the table. On the select command, we indicate which columns we would like to display, like title and place in this case, and indicate which table we want to retrieve the data from. So again, it is from the table called as tracks. Now we have the syntax as select title, place from tracks, where title and place are name of columns you want to display data from, and tracks is the name of the table. So basically, this statement tells us that we want to fetch title and place column records from the table called as tracks. Now, after the select command, we use the for loop to display all the records. Now, when you execute this program in your Python shell, you see that the for loop finds two rows, and each row is a Python tuple with the first value as the title and the second value as the number of place. So as you can see here, we have a table named tracks with two columns, title and place, and there are two rows of data. So till here we have been using this structured query language, that is SQL, in our Python examples and have covered most of the basics of the SQL commands, like the select statement, then we used the insert command, we also used the drop command, and so on. In this section, we will look at the SQL language in particular and give an overview of the SQL syntax. Let us see what is SQL and why is it important. So, to perform operation on databases, one should use structured query language, that is SQL. Now, SQL is a standard language for storing, manipulating, and retrieving data in databases. Then, irrespective of RDBMS software like Oracle, MySQL, MS Access, SQLite, etc. being used, the syntax for SQL remains the same. Here, as I had already told you, RDBMS is nothing but Relational Database Management System software. And finally, the usage of SQL commands may vary from one RDBMS to the other, and there may be a little syntactical difference. Also, one thing to remember is that when we are using some programming languages like Python as a front end to perform database applications, the way we embed SQL commands inside the program source code is as per the syntax of the respective programming language. It means that Python will have its own syntax to execute SQL commands. However, the underlying SQL commands remain the same. That is, there is no change in the commands, but only the way you write makes the change depending upon the programming language you are going to make use of. So now, before actually working with all the commands and data types of SQL, let us first look at the commands and data types available in SQL. So the following table gives few of the SQL commands. Here, the command create database creates a new database. The alterDB command is used to modify a database. The createTable command creates a new table, as we have already seen. The alterTable command modifies a table. The dropTable command deletes the table, as we already saw in tracks example. The select command extracts data from the database. InsertInto command inserts data into the database. The update command updates data. And finally, delete command deletes data from a database. So here, one thing that we observe is delete and drop is different. And what is the difference? The difference is that delete is used to remove tuples, that is one or few rows from a table, and drop is used to remove the entire table from the database. So remember this. So why is delete used? Delete is used to remove one or more records from a table, whereas drop is used to entirely delete the table. Next, we have a table representing data types in SQL. So as I mentioned earlier, every RDBMS has its own way of storing the data in tables. Now, each of these RDBMS uses its own set of data types for the attribute values to be used. SQLite uses the data types as mentioned in the following table. So the data type null represents a null value, integer represents signed integer, real represents an 8-byte floating point number, the text data type represents a text string, and blob blob represents binary large objects of data, which is stored exactly as it was input. Now the example for this blob data type is Word documents, PDF invoices, photos, product images, and so on. So this was about today's lecture. where we started with the insertion of records into a table. Then we moved towards SQL summary, where we got introduced to the data types and commands to be used in SQL. So that's all for today. In the next video, we will see how to use these statements, commands, and data types. Thank you.